Sometimes the light's all shining on me. Other times I can barely see.
Elemental Jujutsu has been formed and tried and tested and refined and distilled down over the last over 20 years as Jerry, myself, Tara, John, Cindy, and Jody, and others, we've worked with different masters, including Mickey Whittakin, Tammy Schaefer, Jim Thompson, Joseph Walker, Michael Talkington, and of course, Philip Porter, and brought our techniques together and worked with various arts and various artists to make sure that we understood that we had those movements that work across the board, that we could find ways to adapt to any situation, and then brought them together under the umbrella of our monkey rules so that they could be taught from a living, dynamic situation and built upon and built upon. And then we developed our transitions, our flows, grouping the grapples together into a seven flow that really encompasses the basis of these grapples. And then expanded the 15 flow, which covers all the grapples that we teach. We brought our chokes into flows, so that way our students learn to transition from move to move. Whenever the opponent presents an opposition or attempt at escape, we can transition into that next move and be ready. We've done the same with our throws, teaching transitions from one throw into a next, from one style of throwing into the next, so that we are continuously adapting to whatever the situation presents. We don't cover every possible situation, but by covering as many as we can, we enable the student to find those adaptations when the need is there. Elemental Jujutsu is predicated on the idea that we need to teach the basics. It's all about the basics. Once you understand the basics of movements, everything else can follow. Once you understand the basics of what a grapple is, the torquing of an arm as far as it'll go in one direction and applying a second direction or third direction, you can extrapolate from that all the infinite variations of all these grapples. Distilled it down to 15 basic grapples, 23 throws, 15 Aikido projections, 10 chokes, 10 kicks, 12 angles of hand strikes, 4 elbows. And from all of that, everything else can flow. All the blocks are distilled down into our monkey rules. So we have a living combat activity, a living fight activity that shows the student that they can deal with that hand coming at them no matter how fast and still find their grapples and their throws and what techniques they need to successfully defend themselves. By teaching the basics and reinforcing the basics, we develop a student that's well-rounded, versatile, and that thinks and that can extend what they've been taught into so many new things that we haven't maybe shown, but that are logical deductions of the basics. In a new art, there always needs to be a discussion of strategy and tactics. And these ideas, they're so hard to differentiate between other arts. Many arts embody the same thoughts that we do in terms of our strategy, in awareness and sensing the intention of our opponent, in reacting as simply as possible initially to nurture every living thing. Again, with attacking what's attacking you and using atemis not just as strikes to vital points, but also as strikes to create off balance, strikes to take your opponent's mind away from what he's doing, and so that frees up and makes it less of a strength on strength contest where pure technique and finesse can win the day. Our tactics lie in the use of the monkey rules. From those, we can control what is happening with our opponent, what is happening in the fight. We can take back the initiative. We can go from these monkey rolls. Anytime a strike is thrown, we can respond with the monkey roll. We can then choose what we do next. We can simply do the block and step back. We can come in with a grapple. We can push them off, or we can begin striking. We have the fullest range of responses available because it's encompassed in our basics. We take these ideas, our tactics, and we mesh them with the idea that I want to preserve the peace. I don't want to fight if I don't have to. If I do have to fight, I need to restore harmony in the situation as fast as possible. I need the fight to end as fast as possible. And I'm going to nurture every living thing. And I will only take my counter offensive, my initiating attacks, to the point that I need to defuse the situation, to control the attacker, or to make them realize that they don't need to be in this fight. This video has been a compilation of all the techniques required in hand-to-hand combat from our students from white belt to first degree black belt. On top of these techniques, there are several weapon techniques in kata that we teach and that students must be proficient in. And then following the black belt, it becomes much more about flows and transitions, being able to adapt to the reality of hand-to-hand combat. And we get far more in-depth into pressure point use, muscle grabs, in each of our techniques. Thank you for considering elemental jiu-jitsu as a new style of jiu-jitsu and for watching our video.